Hey guys, it's Burgos here, and today I'm going to show you how to do Heretical Ruins. I'm going to also give you a tips how to avoid one specific spell that is a game changer for this boss. And basically, this is the new mechanic in the Season 4, but this strategy can be applied to all seasons. Now, first, just a short overview for the people who don't know. This is the spells that this boss is doing. Applying attack penalty, burn also. Going for invisibility, 100% of the damage taken converts into healing. Very important to be known, because this is basically the most important thing here. Burn deals AoE damage and control immunity. So this is the boss. This is my team. I have Karl, I have Sigrid, I have Garius, I have Pikestone, I have Voresh. Now, in general, all these heroes are AoE heroes, and I use them in the Goblin Lair, just because for me it's way more easy to use one team in the couple places. So be picky when you pick your teams at the beginning of the season. Very important if you want to be a competitive. So yeah, let's directly just start the fight, and I'm going to show you for what to watch about. Currently, all of my heroes are okay, so I'm going to just put them, because right now there is no issue to actually get some healing to the boss. Here we're going to try to avoid healing of the boss. I'm going to stop my heroes, or maybe I'm going to leave them, by the way. And you're going to see that the boss is going to remove everything. And this is the important part, because the boss is going to start getting some healing. Now, the purpose of this video is that, okay, do you see that? Basically, the boss, okay, he have his debuff removed, but I'm going to just take out all of my heroes doing damage, and I'm going to just show you what is going to happen when there is a debuff on the boss. And right now we have debuff on the boss, so you can see that the healing, see, this is massive healing. Basically, the boss regenerate like 30% from the damage I actually did. It's coming till here. So it's with crucial importance to have a hero that is removing buffs, or that is giving some debuff prohibition. And you're going to wait a specific moment where this thing disappear. Now he's having this, is going to refresh from time to time, and at some point is going to disappear. And this is the moment we're going to strike. Okay, we strike with everything. Oh my god, oh my heroes die. Oh my heroes die. But yeah, I'm just going to make it short, when this thing actually disappear and how to actually do some damage. At the beginning, you can fire up all of your heroes, and most likely the first two cycles your heroes is going to do pure damage, because they're not going to catch up with this healing that the boss is going to receive when the boss is get hitted. Basically, 100% from the damage is converted to healing. But yeah, after this, you're going to see right now all of my heroes is going to shoot again. This is not an issue. But the moment the boss catch my heroes with this healing part, is going to be the moment things is going to slowly reverse. And most likely this boss, there is an even chance to actually, okay, as you can see, he do the spell before my hero. As you can see here, he start getting healing. This is on the cycle 3. So yeah, we have to just stop our heroes and just wait a little. Wait a little, this spell disappear. And after this spell disappear, is going to be the moment where we're going to strike and we're going to do the big damage. And basically not healing the boss. Okay, the boss is getting this this thing, and he's going to go down at some point. Okay, now is the time. Boom, boom, boom. This is the most easiest way that you can do for this boss. Of course, my heroes here most likely may actually die, but we don't care about this. And in the next cycle, there is a chance again the boss to not catch you. It just sometimes need manually to do that, but I think in general it's an easy boss, and this is the most easiest way to do it, because this healing is a game changer for the Heretical Ruins. And like this, you can go to stage 9. Of course, you can use some heroes to remove these buffs. But yeah, it didn't actually matter. I mean, if you're going to use this type of hero, most likely it's going to take one place for good DPS you can use. And you can just do the waiting part, or you can do it on auto with a hero that is removing buffs. So yeah, I guess this will be for this video, guys. I really hope it was helpful for you. Like, subscribe, and see you in the next one.